Class of 2016, you may be seated. Wow, we look so good. Let's get the speech started. Finally, all those long hours of homework and studying all night have paid off, and we made it. I couldn't be any happier than to graduate with one of the best classes, and that is the class of 2016. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Vanessa Hernandez, and I am honored to deliver the 2016 Moment of Reflection speech. I want to thank everyone for blessing me with this amazing opportunity to represent the class of 2016 at our graduation, because it is something I always wanted to do. But before I get going on with my speech, I want to welcome my fellow classmates, parents, friends, and faculty of DCHS that are present with us today. As I began writing this speech, I found myself reflecting on my 4 years of high school, and I thought to myself, these years have taught me so much, and I can't believe I am finally graduating. I have to admit that these past 4 years went by so fast, and I will cherish every little moment. I found out that high school is like a picture frame. In order to capture the perfect moment, we have to make the best out of it. Freshman year, we were all looking different directions, and we were unsure of what we wanted to do. This was the year where we were booed at the pep assemblies, and then sophomore year came, and that year we were no longer underclassmen, and it was the year where we wrote our first research paper and started taking challenging classes. We started getting involved with many clubs and activities. Then junior year came, and it was 1 year closer to graduation. This year was the year where we helped out with prom, but let's not forget that that year was the year where we put on the lip dub. Finally, senior year came along and we got infested, with senioritis. It was a hassle waking up each morning and making it to school on time. This was the most exciting senior year because our football team brought the hatchet back home where it belongs. I apologize for the slang, but I have to definitely say that game was lit. We finally made it and we got through the ups and downs. However, I want to share a story about this boy I met during high school. We have been best friends and I will always have him in my heart. I was not aware how close we would be, and many times my friends told me to stay away from him. At the beginning of our relationship, he wouldn't pay attention to me, and things felt like they didn't fit well between us because he had so many friends he paid attention to. I stuck to this boy's side through the ups and downs, and I realized that he was the perfect boy for me. He introduced me to people who I now call my best friends. For the past 4 years, I have been in a relationship with this boy. We have shared many memories where we have enjoyed dissecting fetal pigs, dancing at prom, and finishing the Dodger. I have cherished all the moments we've spent together, and I couldn't be any happier with any other boy. However, the relationship I once had with this boy will never be the same, because a few days ago, he died in my life. This boy's name is Dodge City High School. I hope my parents' blood pressure is back to normal. We all share this common best friend, Dodge City High School. We should never forget this friend who brought laughter into our lives. I will never forget all the memories I made here at DCHS. I will never forget the struggle of passing Hendrix's physics class and staying up all night studying for Deuce's AP government class. I will never forget staying at school till 9 p.m., editing and finishing the Dodger issue. I will never forget listening to Mrs. Luter's life stories and how she once told me that you have to go through the bad in order to get to the good. I will never forget the feeling of being stuck in the school traffic each morning hoping to make it on time. I will never forget being under the Friday night lights with the best student section and getting hyped up to the awesomest band, the pride of Southwest Kansas. And most importantly, I will never forget the people I grew up with. These 4 years have truly challenged, helped, and pushed me to become the person I am today and prepare me for college. I want to leave you with one of my favorite quotes that has helped me get through my life. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Psalm 37:4. Graduates, whatever you decide to do after today, do something you will enjoy and love for the rest of your life. People will try to bring you down, but don't let the bitterness of people change you. Always be bold, be different, and be courageous. Never forget where you came from. Once a red demon, always a red demon. Thank you.
Take the high road to your dream. I'm really glad that as we get our diplomas today, that it doesn't come with a height requirement because I probably wouldn't pass. But I digress. Is this okay? Yeah.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.
Do, 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 damn. And it goes on like that. Thank you, guys. That's as funny as it's gonna get. Obviously, you guys aren't at a rock concert, and this certainly isn't the year 1976. But the chorus you just heard came from the famous rock song, Carry On My Wayward Son, by the band Kansas. The song runs a meaning with multiple interpretations that range from religion to Greek mythology, while others suggest, you know, it could be about John Brown, the abolitionist of the 1800s. And some would even assume to say that it's about the struggles of teenage adolescency. But I know for me, it's about overcoming my fear of failure, never giving up, and finding peace when I am finished. I believe the spirit of this song can transcend between the generations, all of us in here, and we can find a meaning in it. And so, as we are here today to celebrate in our accomplishments, I'd like that we all, that the class of 2016 join me in embracing our new journey that begins today as we carry on. And I want you all to know that I'm deeply moved and honored to speak before all of you. You know, it is a really big honor, and I have something to confess. I really enjoy public speaking, if you couldn't tell. Yet, even though I'm kind of up here shaking a little bit, because I'm nervous about embarrassing myself in front of all of you, and these past couple of weeks, I've really been dwelling on these thoughts of fear and doubt. And while dwelling on these, I came to the realization that maybe I'm not the only one. I know that for many of us, we were so ready to get on, get out of high school, be done with homework. We were so ready to get out and start a new life. But then suddenly, it hits you. It's the doubt. These what ifs, you know? What if I don't make it? What if I don't succeed? What if my plans don't go the way I want them to? What if college isn't for me? And the truth is, fear comes with every changing wind. The following verse of Wayward Son goes on to say, once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse of what's beyond this illusion. So guys, don't be afraid to see what fear really is. Fear is just an illusion. Okay, going on with this, I'm sorry. My challenge for all of you today is to never give up. I'm gonna leave you with a couple of these, and this being my first one. And I've always enjoyed the profound words of the movie character Rocky Balboa.
Yo, Adrian.
No, not these words, but something more like this.
You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. And it ain't about how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward.
I know we've all suffered and struggled, and I've had my own personal setbacks within my own life. This past 9/11, I suffered an injury at a home football game. I broke my tibia. Some of you were aware of that. And this injury derailed my completion of the application process to attend the United States Naval Academy. I can recall while I was sitting on the doctor's, you know, bed and he was describing what was happening to me, I just felt overwhelmed with everything, a lot of emotions. For a long time, I was devastated. Though, however, I want you all to know that through the support of my family, friends, and faith, I was able to overcome that. And I plan to do my best at whatever I do. I plan to do better next time. And I plan to reapply to the Naval Academy. And I plan to send in more applications and do better than I did before. And maybe, just maybe, they'll let me in. But I want you all to know that I share with you this story as a testimony that no matter how hard life hits you, you get back up and you try again. Because we all share this potential We all can rise up every time we fall. We can do this, guys. I remember my abuelita, who's somewhere out there in the audience, she always used to tell me, "Sí se puede." Yes, you can. My other challenge for you is to be the best that you could be at whatever you do. Whether you want to become a nurse, a police officer, a truck driver, or even the President of the United States. Surprise people. Astonish them. Let them know who you are. You know, one of my favorite animated movies growing up is The Iron Giant. Maybe you guys have heard of it, yeah? Yeah. So, in the movie, a giant robot alien crashes to Earth and he befriends a kid. And at the climax of this movie, this giant is struggling with his identity. He's confused as to whether he's some negative force, you know, for destruction, a war machine, or he's some force for good, you know? And it's at this moment that the child, Hogarth, the kid he befriends, comes forward to him and says, "Giant, you are who you choose to be. You choose. You choose." So I'd like to challenge you guys with that today, that to be the best that you can be, I challenge you to choose who you want to be and be the best. Be Superman or Superwoman. Your choice. The next thing I'd like to say is, I know that we've, like I said before, had our own trials and tribulations for many of us, and I want you guys to know that this is a very resilient class. In fact, we're so resilient, we survived Ebola. If we can do that, we can survive anything. Of course, now there's the Zika virus, but that's neither here nor there. That's for the next class. And I know that this past Friday, this past Thursday, we had some disappointment at Memorial Stadium. And I want you guys to know, those athletes that competed that day, that don't take it too hard on yourselves. This school still has a lot to be proud of, and it should be proud of its athletes. We have won multiple WAC titles, and that's nothing to be ashamed of. And for those who aren't athletes, we've gotten superior ratings and many other activities. We're an awesome school, aren't we? Yeah. As a famous poet, philosopher, Drake, once stated, "We started from the bottom, and now the whole team's here." So not only can we say that we did our best at the West, no, not only can we say we're the best in the Western Athletic Conference, we can also say that we own the hatchet, right? We are the class of 2016. We are Dodge City, and I'd like you guys to repeat this chant with me. We are
Dodge City.
We are
Dodge City.
I said we are
Dodge City.
That's right, guys. We are Dodge City. We're the class of 2016, and we're the best, and we're ready to carry on. And my last challenge for you today is to find your purpose by pursuing your passion. I think no one says it better than California girl, Katy Perry. Find your passion and nurture it. I know that I'm still lost in what I'm meant to be, but I know that for many of us, we have many gifts. Gift of speaking, writing, intelligence, intellects, dancing, singing, whatever it may be. Find it and nurture it. The following verse of Wayward Son goes on to say, "If I claim to be a wise man, well then it surely means that I don't know. And the truth is, I don't know everything. But I know that I have something to offer to society and to the rest of us. And I know that all of us also have this same potential. We can do our best and give everything we have." And I think no one says it better than Terry Orklick, a professor of sports psychology. "The heart of human excellence begins to beat when you discover a pursuit that absorbs you, frees you, challenges you, and gives you a sense of meaning. Don't be afraid to pursue your gifts. Nurture them. They may be the key that ignites your passion, that will give you and sustain you for the rest of your life." And the final lines of Wayward Son go on to say, "Carry on. You will always remember. Carry on. Nothing equals the splendor. Carry on. Now your life's no longer empty." Finally, we are here today because someone cared for us. Someone wanted us to succeed. Someone pushed us and encouraged us. So for all of those out there who are willing to take in the responsibility of raising a child, Thank you so much. This moment is for you too. This is for those parents who stayed up late at night to earn a college degree so that they could provide you guys with a roadmap to success. It is for those families that migrated here from another country to give you a better opportunity. This is for that guardian that raised you and took you in as their own so that they could give you the opportunity to do more than they ever dreamed themselves. This is for that single parent who raised you and your siblings on their own so that you could walk up here today and get your diploma and maybe become the next Bill Gates or Nicki Minaj. So let's please give a round of applause to those who raised us. And as I finish here today, I would like to say I love you, Mom and Dad, and a shout out to my fam. And a special shout out to my senior class, and I love you guys. And remember, never give up. Always do your best. Live your life with a purpose. Thank you all so much. God bless, and carry on.
Hey, Yvonne, don't run off of that stool. I might need it. It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness. It was the epoch of belief. It was the epoch of incredulity. It was the season of light. It was the season of darkness. Charles Dickens. For me, this quote represents two things. One, it shows the roller coaster of emotions we jumped onto in August. And two, it reminds you that Charles Dickens is extremely wordy, and you never have to read him again! Seriously, there are about six more comparisons before he gets to the point. Much like Charles, I seem to have strayed from mine. My point being that this time is one of great potential. We're graduating high school and going off to become adults, which is terrifying because I still can't do mental math. You can laugh, it's okay. We're going off to become the next generation of doctors, lawyers, and Kardashians. Okay. Joseph Campbell was an American scholar who redefined the classical hero from the standards set forth by the playwrights of ancient Greece. A man whose work led to the creation of The Da Vinci Code, Star Wars, and Harry Potter. Campbell was responsible for the monomyth, or the process a protagonist will go through to succeed in his quest. I like to consider myself involved in the arts, especially theater, and if theater has taught me anything, it's taught me that everyone has a story, that everyone is the protagonist in their own lives, that yes, everyone is stupid enough to sell an entire cow for four magic beans. That being said, I'd like to take a moment to show each and every one of you how you have all earned the right to call yourself a hero. Step one, the ordinary world. From elementary school to middle school, we lived in a naive bliss, immune to and unknowing of the great adventure which awaits us. Then again, middle school was mostly just a cloud of acts anyways. Step two, the call to adventure. Freshman orientation. That glorious night when we first stepped into the auditorium to hear all about this magical new place we were going to be spending the next 4 years of our lives attending. Step three, supernatural aid. In many cases, this would present itself as a wise and experienced person, maybe a teacher or an older sibling. But for many of us, it was the internet. Many a time we would feel overwhelmed and unsure how we were going to fit everything we needed to do into one night, when suddenly, the holy light of the iPad notification burst forth and reminded us of websites like Schmoop to pull us on through. And also, where would we be without BuzzFeed? I mean, really. Step four, crossing the threshold. At last, we had grown prepared enough to enter the hallowed halls of this magical realm. This was the moment all our excitement had been building to. Maybe we even got up a little early to make sure everything was exactly where we needed it. The energy was tangible. The excitement was palpable. The mysteries unknowable. And they would remain that way for a very long time. Because, class of 2016, we were all about to learn just how long the line is to get into the high school. Step 5, challenges and temptations. Now past the threshold and entered the magical world of high school, it was time to face the challenges of this strange place. And boy, was it full of challenges. Finding your classes, the lunch line, doing your homework, the lunch line, summer PE, and the lunch line, just to name a few. And even though we couldn't always ask out that cute girl in biology, things had a way of coming together at just the right time to remind us that high school is an incredible place and that we, as a student body, are extremely lucky to have the staff that we do. Step 6, the abyss and transformation. The darkest point in our lives where all hope seems lost. I'm sure at some point this year, we've all felt the cruel sting of senioritis. And whether it was Spirit Week, when boys decided to wear short shorts, or the last day of spring break when you realized there was a government test that you had not studied for. It was almost impossible to continue on that arduous 4-year quest when, out of the glorious haze, the final quarter struck us like lightning. Suddenly, we had a mere 9 weeks left before our glorious victory in the battlefields of McCarty, Chagrou, Hoover, and Tolson. And that allowed us to push on to the final step. Step 7, return to the ordinary world. Here it was that our cycle began anew. Our once magical world has become the ordinary world from which we have heard our next call to adventure, whatever that call may be. Each of us has walked a different path, fought a different fight, had different mentors and skills, but we all completed the journey. I know we are destined to succeed in the next quest because we know how to be heroes. That's the wonderful truth behind Joseph Campbell's work. It's not a straight line moving towards the end like a bullet. It's a cycle. When one door closes, another opens. Success isn't always a linear path. We're about to go forth and change the world. And as we do, remember that you are the hero and that this is your story. I believe that J.K. Rowling said it best. All was well. Thank you.
I don't know how I'm supposed to follow that up. Those were really good speeches. Okay. My name is Natalie Baeza, for those of you who do not know me. I was given the honor of being the class historian for the class of 2016. My job today, as historian, is to take us all through the many years of school we have been through together and revive the memories of growing up alongside each other and leading up to this special moment. Our class has lived through some of the best moments ever. We lived the moment of hiding our tears when we wanted Nemo's dad to find him, and also mimicking the Incredibles while our parents just watched us demand to know why we didn't have super suits. Then, when they told us to use the sheet as a cape, we would rant about how Edna would chew them out if she would have heard them. We were there when the Space Cadet pinball game was living its last years on our huge dinosaur PCs. And we all got frustrated because we couldn't keep the ball up for more than a minute each try. I remember that game got me so frustrated, I'm pretty sure I heard dinging in my sleep. Okay. Before technology was as advanced as it is today, we actually went out and rode bikes. We played hopscotch, jump rope, and had contests with the neighbor's kids to see who could hold a hula hoop up the longest. Everything was fun in the sun for the longest of times, and then our lives in the classroom came along. 2003 was a year of importance. The new millennium began, and we were introduced to the 21st century. Little did anyone know, the 21st century was about to be introduced to a bunch of butt-kicking, legendary kindergartners. This was the year we all strapped on our backpacks and were decorated with the characters ranging from the Powerpuff Girls to the Wiggles. We all met a bunch of strangers our own age who would later become some of our closest friends and who we would share our 64-pack of crayons with. We all know that whoever had that pack was a stud. This was the beginning of the next 13 chapters of our lives. I still remember walking into school at Lynn Elementary and meeting the principal, Miss Deegis, who is now working at the high school, and being taken to the gym for my first day with Miss Schneewise. My favorite part of every day until the fourth grade was when we all got to see Miss Armstrong, and she would teach us to sing and dance for the programs we put on. Every once in a while, I can still hear her sing. Miss Mary Mack, 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 all dressed in black, black, black. And then I think of how much I miss us all singing along. We were all the best of friends, and we were tiny, energetic goofballs. I remember getting cupcakes on someone's birthday, and we gave our crushes an extra lollipop on Valentine's in hopes that they would get a clue. But sometimes they didn't. Elementary school was the greatest until we got the first glimpse of a nightmare that would get worse and worse through the years. This nightmare was homework. We were led into that trap with fun stuff like coloring, but next thing we knew, we were doing nothing but long division and fractions. But I guess we all need our edumacation, am I right? Eventually, we had to say goodbye to our teachers, and we faced the fear of entering a new school. Fifth and sixth grade was new beginnings for most of us. We met people from other elementary schools, and we howled alongside them every morning now that we were Comanche Coyotes. I mean, unless you went to school, then I feel sorry that you had to miss out on this event. Letters were introduced to math, reading was truly poetic, social studies was the most boring thing ever, and science was taught by a strange man who nailed the Napoleon Dynamite dance at the school talent show. That's you, Mr. Cop. I don't know if you're in here, but that was pretty good. We were also introduced to the wonderful world of instruments. I'm surprised our orchestra teacher, Miss Mickey, did not wear earplugs because we were horrible, okay? It was bad. Next thing you know, there would be a loud sour note in the room next door from a clarinet. We were either band geeks or orchid dorks. I want to apologize to our parents for the next couple of years, our early teen years. We were all rebels, and we believed that we didn't need anybody because we were adults. Adults. All anyone ever received was a sigh or an eye roll. In our defense, we couldn't even handle our own sassiness. DCMS was a new chapter for most of us here today. We were labeled Smurfs with blue, white, and khaki colors we wore. It kind of sucked when we would get a conduct for forgetting to tuck in our shirts. We were the Cardinals, and now sports were introduced to us. We were athletes and club goers, which made socializing much more important now that there were cliques. An important topic was always, who's dating who, and is little Jimmy taking Sarah to the dance? Those aren't real people, by the way. The days of equal Valentines were over, and there would always be that one person walking around with that huge, ridiculously oversized bear. Then we would hear Mr. Small yell at someone with his New York accent and say, what are you gonna do with that huge thing? Live in it, you weirdos? And then he would continue to make teenage boys run out of the room traumatized after seeing a video of the circle of life. As we wrote our essays, we would blast Katy Perry through our iPods, and I'm pretty sure we would end up dancing instead of doing homework. We became familiar with all-nighters and finals. We had the stress of getting good grades and being great kids overall. The eight classes of day helped us begin to explore our possibilities along with extracurriculars. And we didn't realize that we were getting into a similar routine that, like the one we would have in high school. I bet right about now some of you are thinking, not all of us went to public schools. I got you guys covered. The Sacred Heart colors were white and red, and you guys wore uniforms that were red, blue, and khaki. You were the Mighty Cougars. I did some asking, and here's what I got. This is a small school with a big heart. Everyone grew up together until eighth grade. You guys were practically a family, but the competition was real. Everyone tried to show off with their spelling bees, geography bees, religion bowls, and math competitions. There were the socials that the parents hosted and the prayer before every meal. The school was small and a new student was a huge deal. Sacred Heart sounds like a good simple school where everyone wanted to get ahead in life and succeed. But my personal favorite part of asking my friends who went to Sacred Heart about their experience was when they would tell me a story of when they were being mischievous. These are funny. Some of these stories included a corn dog slap fight, being awed when a student killed a wasp midair, and also one of my friends admitted to breaking a fan and bragged about how he never got caught. And then there was the closet. We won't talk about this because not even I was told what that's about. All of us came from different experiences, but we all came together for the best years of our education. It was time for us to become freshmen and slowly begin to move into adulthood when we had to do our own laundry instead of it magically appearing on our beds. High school was our rite of passage into becoming grown-ups. Ugh. We entered a school full of schedules, clubs, and a bunch of events we wanted to attend. This was when we all became a part of something. It is really hard to not be involved in something because there's so much to do. There was sports, groups, clubs, and even a class could feel like something, like a group, if it's fun enough. We all met the new administrators and teachers. We met the wrath of Steiner and his list of unexcused absences. Feist would always be running around school somewhere, and DJ just clung to her walkie-talkie like her life depended on it. There was Lampy, Martinez, and Hartzler, who would all of a sudden show up in your classroom. When this happened, you knew to act normal, meaning don't zone out in the middle of class. Every day was a fast and furious reenactment to get to class. We learned to cope with the hectic lunch lines and morning chaos with traffic. All of us had already connected with our friends to make sure we didn't end up sitting alone with strangers at lunch. We each began building student-teacher relationships, and they were our mentors. We took different classes, some of us took regular classes and other honors. There were many more teachers, and each of them gave us a new experience. Freshman year was our time to get settled in and learn the ropes of being in high school. We were the newbies, and we got picked on all the time because we were underclassmen. This meant that we were initiated into the school by being booed at pep assemblies. Sophomore year was a lot easier. We knew what we were doing, and now we even sometimes helped the freshmen. By this time, everyone had something to do. We were athletes, there were the theater kids, there were brainiacs, the entrepreneurs, and so many others. We had survived the freshman year booings, and we were moving into learning what we wanted in life. This was our transition year. We were beginning to feel the freedom of driving, and some of us managed to get jobs. We found our own groove. Junior year was a difficult year. We were now upperclassmen with a lot more responsibility. The class difficulty went up a notch if you were brave enough to take an AP class. We had to worry about the ACTs and make sure we didn't oversleep for a 4-hour test that began at 8 a.m. That was frustrating. The college brochures began to arrive, and we all began to think of the decisions as to where we're going to go for college. All-nighters were a lot more intense and sometimes consisted of two or more energy drinks. The seniors were those who we looked up to. They looked like they had everything in place as we were about to take their place. The one thing they didn't take was prom. That was ours. Senior year finally arrived, and we were full of anticipation for the year to end, even though it hadn't even begun yet. All we thought was, yes, finally no more high school. But slowly yet surely, the idea of the routine we were used to ending was starting to sink in. This year, the excitement for everything amplified by like 1,000. We cheered louder, played harder, and performed better because we knew that those were our last moments as DCHS students. Proof of this is that most of our sports teams won WAC this year. It's pretty awesome that the tennis team won WAC after 27 years and made it to regionals for the first time. Yeah. The pride of Southwest Kansas has received superior ratings all 4 years that we've been here. Way to go, guys. We had peers go to state for playing instruments or for group competitions like those with an amazing voice who can debate your ears off as well. Our archery team is a 2-time state champion. I hope that's right because I didn't really know that. And last but not least, Dodge has the hatchet. We attended every last event we could be at and played our part in putting most of these events together. We wanted to make sure we didn't miss anything. There were the dances, blood drives, musicals, plays, concerts, games, meets, and so much more to see and do. It's really hard to fit all of it into one last amazing year. Senior year, we met the teachers who would give us advice for the future, like Mr. Dusso, who would never sugarcoat it and answer our questions honestly. Then we had Hendrix's class, where we all got super frustrated when she would tell us to solve the problem on our own because that's what our lives would be like. If we ever wanted a pep talk, we would go talk to Coach Foster because his pep talks are so great. Sometimes he made me feel like I could run a mile. I never did, but almost. We have our friends who help us out, and sometimes they become our second families, who we won't lose contact with even after we separate to different colleges. This year, I became close to many people who I never expected would be there. I would name you guys off, but you guys know who you are. I love you guys. Love you too, I don't know who that was. All excitement aside, this is our time to get serious. We are becoming independent now, and we're finally going off to become the successful people we want to be. By this time next year, we could quite possibly be broke college students with a whole new level of staying up and cramming for finals. We will no longer have our parents to look up to when the doctor asks, what seems to be wrong? Yes, guys, that means we're gonna have to explain all on our own, instead of awkwardly sitting there as mom talks. We will be fully responsible for ourselves, and we won't be able to yell, Mom, have you seen my left Sperry? Or has anyone seen my homework? We will have bills, and those times that we made fun of our dads for being bald will haunt us in our sleep. Adulthood is scary and sounds like a lot of work, but we can get through it. We've gotten through all of this, right? I would like to make a request for my fellow graduates to give a round of applause for those who are here for us tonight, for our parents and guardians who have helped us through all of it all. Even though we made inappropriate jokes, we would never shut up and got really annoying every once in a while. Remember, they're the ones who listened to us sing along to Frozen, even though that wasn't even intended for our age group. So everyone give a round of applause to your parents. There's so much adventure ahead of us. Yet, we will find ourselves missing these days in our youth when we had a sport to be part of and those classes where we would be excited to find a familiar face in class. We will miss the classes we enjoyed with the best teachers and the people who we shared them with. It will be the little things, like whenever I walked into Miss Luter's on Country Friday and hearing that one person always complaining about how country is the worst music ever. Angel. There is also the club meetings to plan an event that is going to happen. We will no longer have pep assemblies, and we will no longer cheer as a class, which we did in the back, if any of you guys heard us. We were pretty loud. We will miss the bus rides with our teams for places like a game or a competition or a meet. The only thing we probably won't miss is hearing Foster say we have to run shuttles and then seeing the terror in everyone else's faces. Those are not fun. We all have someone to be and somewhere to go. We all want to be happy and successful in life, and hopefully we will be. Just remember to remember where you came from and who you always have been. Remember who your friends are and who was there for you and who you can be there for. To quote one of my favorite songs from Tim McGraw, hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, don't lie. I know you got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when all the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel pride, but always stay humble and kind. I hope to see us all grow into amazing people and become who we want to be. When you miss these times of being a high school student, just remember that no matter where you go in life, you will always be a red demon. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Before I begin to address the class of 2016, I'd like to introduce a few folks here that are here with us this morning. And if you would please stand as I call your name and remain standing for a moment. On the stage this morning, we have our Board of Education with President Lisa Killian, Vice President Tammy West, Board Members Tracy Rankin, Barbara Lundeen, Ryan Osmus, Jeff Hires, and Brian Mushick. Let's give them a round of applause, please. Then over here to my left, we have Central Office Administrators. We have Dr. Glenn Fortmeyer, who's our Assistant Superintendent for Secondary Education. We have William Hammond, who's our Executive Director of Business and Operations, and Ray Whiff, who's our Executive Director of Management Information Services. So thank you, gentlemen, for being here. Now, class of 2016, on behalf of your fellow students, the faculty and staff of Dodge City Public Schools and the Board of Education, I congratulate you on your achievement. We're proud of you, and I'm very certain that everyone that's here with you, your friends and your family, are celebrating with you and care deeply about your success. As a class, you've excelled, and we're honored to have helped you with the skills and knowledge you will use to be successful in your journey in life. I know each of you is excited for the next phase of your life, whether you plan to continue your education, go on into the workforce, join the military, or whatever. I believe that the education you've received in Dodge City has provided a strong foundation for your future success. Your opportunities as a class, as young people, are limitless. Your possibilities are beyond our imagination. I encourage you to never stop learning, especially don't settle for anything that's in your power to change. It's your decisions, your determination, now more than ever, that will turn your hopes and your dreams into realities. You are, from this point forward, the author of your own life story, and what will be written on the next pages and in the next chapters is up to you. We hope that you'll let us, your family, your friends, and your teachers, contribute something to those chapters as well. And I challenge each of you to make your life story something we're all proud to read. As a graduating class, you're united by your school spirit, by pride in your accomplishments, and in a hope for your future. Remember your time at Dodge City High School with pride, and know that your community is proud of you and wishes only good things for you. Congratulations, class of 2016.
Okay, seniors, it is time to prepare to receive our diplomas. First row, if you would please rise.
Abdulwali Abdulhali. David Acevedo. Liliana Teresa Acosta Rodriguez. Mark Stefan Adams. Donaldo Aguero Ramirez. Elvia Aguilar. Alex Agundis. Miguel Angel Alarcón. Suzette Alarcón. Jose Enrique Alarcón Hernandez. Jose Angel Alatorre Ayala. Bryce Allen Albers. Mariela Adalva. Jasmine Aldorete. Jacqueline Almijo Rodriguez. Gabriel Jesus Alvendares Cuadra. Omar Ruiz Alvarez. Sasha Renee Anderson. Majesta Andrews. Nayeli Antonio Hernandez. Holly Lynn Archuleta. Bryant Arcos. Daniel, Isaac Daniel Argumido. Giselle Arjon. Melka Susanna Arkell. Michael Anthony Armentrout. Mauricio Arroyo. Juan Alza. Luis Alberto Avilos. Bryant Andres Avila. Natalie Alexandra Baeza. Manuel Michael Banuelos. Kimberly Barajas. Ever Daniel Barrera. Jonathan Barrientos. Isaac Batista Lara. Desiree Nicole Blanco. Monica Blanco. Tanya Blanco. Cameron Joanne Blankman. Cassidy Jean Blankman. Alyssa Janae Bogner. Martin Byrne. Oscar Esai Bordwine. Sergio Barunda Ruiz. Brianna Marie Bradshaw. Alexander Bruce Brinkley. Taryn Rayleigh Brummett. Juan Carlos Buendia. Billy Vu Bui. Alex Mystique Buller. Sean Michael Burton. Jonathan Cabrera. Ignacio Irving Calderon. Austin Matthew Camacho. Maria Elena Camacho. Oscar Campos. Mariana Carvajal. Elena Ann Marie Carlos. Alexis Navarrete Carrasco. Luis Enrique Carrillo Millan. Alexander Cartagena. Robert Amen Carter. Giselle Casas Sanchez. Uriel Jesus Cerrón. Jeanette Janelle Chavez Catalan. Mauricio Chavez Mendez. Adrian Chavez. Brandon Chavez. Ivan Alejandro Chavez. Joanna Yvette Chavez. Skylar Alexandra Childress. Callista Collins. Edgar Colorado. Idalis Comas. RJ Cooper. Annalise Nicole Correa. Alexis Adeline Cosio. Francisco Ernesto Cota Cota. Brian Cota Valdez. Isabel Marie Cruz. Sean Michael Cruz. Guadalupe Cruz Sanchez. Jose Cuevas. Tyler James Cummings. Maria De La Rosa. Jessica De La Rosa Swastegui. Giovanni Emmanuel Del Riel. Humberto Del Riel. Johnny Del Riel. Leslie De Luna. Carissa Nicole DeVos. Jordan Lee Duell. Karina Diaz Pichardo. Parker Landon Dixon. Jan Delochi. Baltazar Dominguez Pacheco. Christopher Dominguez. Claudia Ruby Don Juan. Jasmine Duarte. Dylan Wade Dupree. Madison Nicole Duran. Christian Elizabeth Louise Edwards. Cody Elwell. Leticia Esparza Lopez. Lauren Nicole Escobel. Tayden Falcon. Robin Farnhammer. Jonathan Aaron Ferguson. Cruz Aaron Fernandez. Breck Nicole Flax. Hunter Flax. Priscilla Flores Asensio. Daisy Flores Leos. Peyton Hunter Friend. Erica Jasmine Galdamez. Adela Gallardo. Yaritza Gallardo Torres. Isaac Gallegos. Roman Diego Galloway. Luis Galvan Gomez. Alexandra Garcia. Gerardo Garcia. Guillermo Antonio Garcia. Juliana Anahi Isabel Garcia. Maria Jasmine Garcia. Ziamara Garcia. Yvette Garcia. Alejandrina Garcia. Vanessa Garcia Lopez. Isabel Garcia Rivera. Adrian Garcia Romero. Leandro Garrido Alvarez. Leonardo Garrido Alvarez. Adrian Gaspar. Jalen Wayne Gifford. Aspen Janae Gilliam. Heidi Rose Gilmore. Logan Ann Gleason. Sharon Gleason. Madea Gomez. Maria Lisbeth Gonzalez Pimentel. Iram Gonzalez. Jasmine Ophelia Gonzalez. Jorge Luis Gonzalez. Yemi Salina Gonzalez. Beatrice Alandra Garnillo. Samantha Elizabeth Green. Princeton Herman Grice. Caleb Gross. Brian Christian Groth. Cindy Guerrero. Miriam Correa Guillen. Angel Ali Gutierrez Medina. Kelly Guzman Romero. Tristan Reno Hampton. Cy Labrea Harding. Bryant Michael Harris. Lee Vaughn Harrison. Jesse Morgan Harshberger. Aaron Nicole Hawkins. Isaiah Gerard Hendershot. Adrian Marquez Hernandez. Alejandro Hernandez. Anna Barbara Olivia Hernandez. Andres Tomas Hernandez. Jose Francisco Hernandez. Lyric Elizabeth Hernandez. Melissa Rafaelia Hernandez. Ariana Vanessa Hernandez Romero. Mike Hernandez. Vanessa Hernandez. Jasmine Herrera Perez. Cassandra Herrera Solorzano. Yesenia Herrera Molina. Mohammed Omar Hershey. Chance D. Hurdle. Thalia Hippolito. Zachary Wayne Howarth. Shakia Hunter. Jamie K. Hughes. Luis Adrian Ibarra Ochoa. Anthony Mark Eisenbart. Juana Yanira Escoy Gonzalez. Abigail Rose Jacobs. Shayla Danae James. Shayla Danae James. Aaron Eduardo Jaramillo. Emmanuel Jimenez Zuniga. Alexis Guadalupe Jimenez. Howard LaVon Johnson. Janae Johnson. Sydney Nicole Kalsher. Matthew Jean-Pierre Carnes. Casey Alexander Cahey. Allison Faith Kime. Kendra Joanne Keith. Mahogany Deshae Kenny. Nicholas Brooks Killian. Christina Marie Kinkler. Alec J. Cohen. Chandel Destiny Kane. Dalton A. Crayenhagen. Cyan Alexis Keeker. Magdaleno Joseph Liel. Mark Leonard Lewis. Rafael Polo Lycon. Cynthia Linares. Juana Denise Lira Olguin. Ivan Lira. Alexandra Nia Christy Long. Ingrid Lopez Enriquez. Uriel Lopez Valles. Lionel Lopez. Lizette Lopez. Paola Lopez. Veronica Jasmine Lopez. Zachary Pedigo. Saira Alguion Macias Torango. Vincent Arthur Macias. Jesse Devante Magana. Lucas Johann Heinrich Mann. Sulema Marbuth. Luis Marino Yamas. Eric Marino Adame. Alondra Marquez. Esmeralda Nadalyn Marquez. Felix Marquez. Eric Marquez Torres. Anthony Joseph Martinez. Israel Martinez. Brooke Mon. Dayton Thomas McGroarty. Adley Barone Medina. Mario Antonio Medina. Chantel Justice Medina. Arlene Medrano Alarcon. Monica Viviana Medrano Rangel. Maybeth Marae Mejia Barrera. Johnny Alexander Melendez. Brian Membreno. Ubaldo Lorenzo Mendez Castillo. Osvaldo Mendez Ibanez. Jessica Elizabeth Mendoza Caz. Cameron James Meredith. Luis Angel Meza Martinez. Anahel Meza Valverde. Giselle Guadalupe Millan. Jennifer Molina Flores. Zalma Patricia Molina. Katie Montalongo. Alan Martinez Morales. Jessica Guadalupe Morales. Marissa Morales. Rooney Marissa Morales. Leslie Karina Moreno Gallegos. Denise Moreno. Danny Moreno. Coraima Yoridia Mota. Itzel Moya Perez. Marisol Munoz. Caleb William Myers. Kirsten Areli Myers. Jacqueline Flores Nahra. Bianca Herrera Navrete. Jasmine Navrete. Jasmine Navarro Lopez. Aaron Gustavo Niave Candarco. Austin Nelson. Huang Nguyen. Taylor Leanne Nichols. Yvonne Ochoa. Valeria Ochoa Cordova. Jennifer Oliveras. Casey Gail Oliveras. Abraham Gilberto Olvera. Luis Daniel Ontiveros Cervantes. Juan Ordonez Lux. Ishmael Jesus Orozco. Kevin Alexander Orozco. Randy Lachelle Orso. Alejandro Ortiz. Johnny Ortiz. Domingo Fernando Osorio. Julissa Ann Rafael. Jennifer Pena. Mariana Perez Pantoja. Julian Perez. Mons William Peterson Spawning. Rachel Phillips. Kayla Marie Pinksterhouse. Sassy Arleth Pinuelas. Micah Brady Paulington. Carlos Ponce Hernandez. Ezekiel Jetson Ponce. Jose Manuel Portillo. George Henry Finley Pyle. Miguel Quinones. Victor Manuel Quinones. Adeline Ramirez Adalba. Noel Eduardo Ramirez Romo. Elise Alexis Ramirez. Evelyn Guadalupe Ramirez. Abril Rayo. Michael Timothy Reardon. Eric Scott Reed. Iqiu Zhen. Aliyah Yasmin Reyes. Rosalinda Arlie Reyes. Ruben Reyes. Derek Allen Rincones. Elizabeth Rios. Edgar Jonathan Rios Ramirez. Anessa de la Luz Rito. Elva Rivas. Ayasamin Rivas. Daisy Rivera Hernandez. Treasure Lynn Roberts. Sergio Allen Robles Pinon. Adriana Rodriguez. David Donovan Rodriguez. Magdalena R. Rodriguez. Josefina Rodriguez Leon. Josian Rodriguez Millan. Michelle Rodriguez Niave. Marisabel Yolanda Rodriguez. Richard Anthony Rodriguez. Zarek A. Rodriguez. Cedric Maurice Rogers. Courtney Ray Rogers. Julian Rojas Ramirez. Saul Rojas. Monica Adriana Romero. Alejandro Romo. Ashley Jocelyn Romo. Catherine Shea Rostetter. Brandon Roy. Angel Aaron Ruiz Lopez. Lucia Ruiz Banuelos. Peter Daniel Sainz Castellanos. Maria Araceli Salas. Juan Salazar. Isaac Omar Salinas. Juan Angel Semaran Ratana. Mireya Crystal San Juan. Eileen Sanchez. Daniel Sanchez. Joseph Alexander Sanchez. Rosalia Sanchez Garcia. Miguel Sanchez Mejia. Aurora Sanchez Negrete. Robert Sandoval. Bianca Jacqueline Santibanez. Rachel Jane Schutze. Dakota Ali Schulte. Harley Renee Scott. Tyler Allen Self. Bailey Lynn Sheeler. Sydney Nicole Shiflett. Tristan Iziel Suentes. Margaret Leona Sitz. Aaron Michelle Slattery. Jacqueline Mayrose Smith. Angel Solorzano. Alma Yorizia Solorzano. Chantel Marie Solorzano. Manuel Bonifacio Soriano. Ruman Armando Sota Estrada. Fernando Soto. Laura Soto. Alexandra Marie Steckline. Aaron Michelle Stevens. Daria Vladislavina Storchai. Reva Ann Sweeney. Caitlin Leanne Tabor. Dustin Thompson. Sonia Nicole Thompson. Madison Lee Teban. Tanner Kenneth Teban. Chelsea Breeze Tinney. Juan Daniel Tonche Niave. Christian Francisco Torres. David Torres Jimenez. Adriana Trejo. F. Cole Trent. Max Robert Trent. Tyler Austin Trent. Alexi Gabriela Treto. Miranda Lynn Treto. Gloria Mariela Umana. Bryce Allen Unruh. Alexandria Marie Udias. Marvin Francisco Valdivia Negrete. Anayeli Valles Rios. Jose Valles. Esmeralda Vargas Trito. Alexis Vargas Vonsaca. Kenya Lizeth Vasquez Cervantes. Leslie Vasquez Rios. Naomi Zamira Vasquez. Fernando Velasquez Cervantes. Cindy Sarai Velez. Jade Vilasing. Alejandra Villagrana Lozano. Yoshi Villalobos. Susan Karina Villegas Perez. Carlos Daniel Vitel Gomez. Mariela Vitel Perez. Logan Waldman. Colin Joseph Walker. Ty Jordan Wallace. Caden Walters. Maya Workantine. Shivana Washington. Trey Michael Weber. Clayton Weil. Gideon Wells. Shannon K. Wenzel. Justin Time Williams. Noah Jacob Williams. Stephanie Marie Wilton Perez. Peyton Rahan Winger. Cecilia Dawn Weiser. Zane Scott Warden. Weston Joseph Wright. Rafael Noe Yavarino. Maritza Isabel Zamora. Hiram Eli Zapata Moya. Nathan Alex Zarate.
Would the graduates please rise? It is my honor and privilege to introduce to you the largest graduating class at Dodge City High School, the class of 2016.